So, Jesus and Paul, am I allowed to get married again? Here's my simple answer from all this conversation biblically. If your divorce resulted from adultery or cruelty, you are free to remarry. I've spent a lot of time just trying to answer one question. My guess is that I've raised more questions than I've answered. But that's part of this conversation, and I just wanted to get the conversation started. But if you were sitting in my office today, there's a few things I want to say to you before you leave. And these are really important, so please listen carefully. First thing I want to say is that repentance and forgiveness is always the best outcome when a marriage is broken and hurting. Always. Marriages are precious. They are worth fighting for. They are worth forgiving for. I have seen the most desperately broken marriages revived into the most beautiful marriages. It can happen to anything, anyone, and to any situation. So it's always the best course of action. Let me say this. If you're grappling with this, it's your decision. I don't have authority to tell you what to do. I'm your shepherd. It's your life. It's your relationship with Jesus. It's your listening to the Spirit. You have to make the decisions, but do not make these decisions alone. Talk to people. Talk to your community. Talk to the Spirit. Talk to your pastors. Talk to your counselor. Make sure you're talking to a lot of people that you trust that will help you grapple with what God is saying in your specific case. Let me say this. There are two people in every divorce. Both of them are responsible to some degree. Now, in some cases, it might be 99% and 1%, but that 1% is a contribution. They're usually a little closer to the center. Everyone's responsible. But in many, many divorces, there is one person who has sinned and deeply wounded the other. If you are the victim, and you are the victim of adultery or cruelty or desertion, you are free to remarry. You are not enslaved to your status. You're not marked with a scarlet letter. You're free. If you are the one who sinned, who wounded the other person, grace covers the sin of divorce too. It does. It's not the unforgivable sin, my friends. Some of you might have been told that at some point. If it is possible to reconcile, if neither of you have remarried, your spouse is still alive, still available, then I would encourage you to go and see if the Spirit can do that. Try. If it's impossible, if the other person has remarried, they've passed away, they refuse, then really grapple with 1 Corinthians 7 and ask God, what's next for you? Let me say this. If your spouse is physically abusing you, get out of the house today. Today. You do not have to put up with that. Do not put up with that. There are friends here that you can go into their home. We will take you in. We'll care for you. We'll help you figure out what's next. But get out of danger. And even in this situation, remember that repentance and forgiveness is always, always the best result. God has rescued these marriages too. He still can. But you staying there will not help that. Let me say this. If you hear me giving you a loophole to get out of a marriage you've become bored with, you are mishearing me. I'm not saying that. I don't know how more clearly I can say that Jesus and Paul were adamant that giving up on a marriage for no biblical reason was forbidden. Marriages are precious. Hang in there. It's hard. It's a covenant. Do the work. Ask God to rescue you.